The Quotient Rule, Level 2. In this video, we will go over more challenging examples that require the use of the Quotient Rule. The following examples require you to really understand the Quotient Rule and combine it with various algebra and calculus concepts learned so far. With that said, let's go ahead and jump straight into the first example. Find the derivative of r of x equals 1 over the quantity x plus 5 times e to the x. Notice that this function seems to be formed solely by the function in the denominator. In order to find the derivative of this function, we actually need to apply the quotient rule. We can think of the constant 1 as our f of x, the height function, and the quantity x times 5 times e to the x as our g of x, the low function. Then, the derivative will be equal to the following expression. Here, the derivative of a constant is just equal to 0, and the derivative of our low function is going to be equal to the following expression, resulting in the final derivative equal to negative times the quantity 1 plus 5 times e to the x over the quantity x plus 5 times e to the x squared. Be on the lookout for these types of functions that seem to be formed by the reciprocal of a function. These types of functions pop out every now and then, and as a result, we can generalize the derivative of these types of functions as follows. The derivative of 1 over g of x is going to be equal to negative times g prime of x over g of x squared. This is commonly known as the reciprocal rule. There is really no need to memorize this rule, because it can be obtained by simply applying the quotient rule. It can be useful to find the derivative like the one in this example. Alright, let's try a slightly more challenging example. Find the derivative of r of x equals x over the quantity x plus 5 over x. Alright, this function looks pretty insane. It seems like we can apply the quotient rule. But before we use the quotient rule, let's rewrite this function into a quotient rule friendly form. We have a complex fraction that can be simplified by rewriting the denominator as a single fraction. And then we can simplify the complex fraction as one single quotient. Now we are ready to apply the quotient rule. We will use x squared as our f of x and the quantity x squared plus 5 as our g of x. Then it is just a matter of substituting these expressions into the quotient rule formula. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and find the derivative of f of x and g of x. The last step is to simplify the numerator by distributing the monomials and by collecting like terms. Doing that yields the final derivative equal to 10x over the quantity x squared plus 5 squared. Alright, let's try a slightly more challenging example. Find the derivative of r of x equals x times the quantity 1 minus 4 over x plus 3. It seems that we have a product of two functions, but also notice that we have a quotient of two functions inside the expression. Before you attempt to find the derivative of any function, it is important to rewrite the expression into a derivative-friendly form. For this function, let's go ahead and distribute the variable x to each term. This way, we obtain an expression that becomes slightly easier to differentiate. In this way, we now have to find the derivative term by term. The derivative of the first term is going to be equal to 1, and the derivative of the second term is a perfect candidate for the quotient rule. We will let 4x be our high function, and the quantity x plus 3 be our low function. Applying the quotient rule, we obtain the following expression. Then, we go ahead and distribute each of the terms in the numerator. Next, we simplify the expression by collecting like terms. In the end, the derivative of r of x is equal to 1 minus 12 over the quantity x plus 3 squared. Always try to write functions into a derivative-friendly form before applying specific differentiation rules. Okay, let's try another example. Find the derivative of r of x equals the quantity x squared plus c squared over the quantity x squared minus c squared. Here, c squared represents a constant, so we will treat it as such when applying differentiation rules. This function requires an application of the quotient rule. We will let the quantity x squared plus c squared be our high function, and the quantity x squared minus c squared be our low function. Applying the quotient rule, we obtain the following expression. Keeping in mind that c squared is a constant when finding the derivative. Next, we go ahead and distribute the terms in the numerator as follows. The last step is to simplify the expression and collect like terms. Doing that, we obtain the final derivative equal to negative 4 times c squared times x all over the quantity x squared minus c squared raised to the power of 2. Alright, the last thing you should be aware of is that you don't need to use the quotient rule every time you see a quotient. Not every function formed by a quotient needs to be differentiated by the quotient rule. At times, it is more convenient to rewrite the quotient first, then use either the product rule or constant multiple rule along with the power rule. For example, the function r of x equals the quantity 2x minus 1 over x squared may look like it requires an application of the quotient rule, but it turns out that we can find a derivative by making use of the product rule by rewriting the denominator as a negative exponent as follows. Alternatively, we can also divide both terms in the numerator by the denominator and then apply the difference rule along with the power rule to find the derivative. Regardless of what method you use, you will obtain an expression that represents the derivative of the function. Depending on your preference, you might want to find the derivative of this function by applying something other than the quotient rule. Similarly, the function 5 over x raised to the power of 3 can be solved by rewriting it as a negative exponent and then applying the power rule. You can also use the quotient rule if you like, but the first method is easier and requires less steps. Lastly, the function x cubed over 5 might look like a potential candidate for the quotient rule, but noticing that this is nothing more than a power function times a constant 1/5, we can find the derivative by applying the power rule. Again, not all quotients require you to apply the quotient rule. Make sure you correctly identify the function before blindly applying a differentiation rule. Alright, now let's go over examples that require us to find an expression for the derivative in terms of the given functions. If p of x and q of x are differentiable functions, find an expression for the derivative of the following function. R of x equals p of x over q of x. Alright, in these types of problems, we need to find an expression for the derivative in terms of the function p of x, q of x, and the respective derivatives. Keep in mind that we only want to find an expression for the derivative. Notice that r of x is formed by the quotient of p of x and q of x. This means that we need to make use of the quotient rule. The derivative of r of x is going to be equal to q of x times p prime of x minus p of x times q prime of x over q of x squared. And this is our expression for the derivative of r of x. If we knew what p of x or q of x were equal to, we can now substitute these functions into our expression that represents the derivative of r of x. Alright, let's try another example. R of x equals p of x over the quantity 1 plus q of x. Similar to the last example, let's go ahead and apply the quotient rule. The high function is p of x, and the low function is the quantity 1 plus q of x. Applying the quotient rule, we obtain the following. The quantity 1 plus q of x times p prime of x minus p of x times q prime of x over the quantity 1 plus q of x squared. We can also distribute p prime of x in the numerator, and we will obtain the following. Either expression is an acceptable answer for the derivative. Keep in mind that we only want an expression for the derivative, given the functions in the numerator and denominator. Okay, let's try one more similar example. R of x equals x squared over q of x. Here we have a function formed by a power function in the numerator and a general function q of x in the denominator. We once again have to apply the quotient rule, notice that we can actually find the derivative of the numerator by applying the power rule. For the denominator, we have no other choice but to write its derivative as q prime of x. Applying the quotient rule and simplifying, we obtain the final derivative equal to the quantity 2x times q of x minus x squared times q prime of x over q of x squared. Alright, in our next video, we will find the value for the derivative of a given function by making use of a set of values and using the graph of functions.